Morning, children. How are you all? Today I am going to take a poem, lesson 3, Windy Night. What is the meaning windy night? The full of wind outside and the night full of wind outside, wind and rain outside. Who has written this poem, Windy Night, you know? R.L. Stevenson. R.L. Stevenson has written this poem, Windy Night. See, what is a, see, look at the picture here. See, a man riding on a horse. And the, see the background, you also see the rain. Rain is falling, wind, high speed, wind also flowing, high speed wind. And the picture, we can understand. The night in the wind, this wind is very high speed and rain. The night, that is why the windy night, the lesson heading is because of that only, windy night. The night full of wind and rain. Whenever the moon and the stars are set, what is the meaning? The moon and the stars are set. The moon and the stars cannot be seen in the sky. You know, night and all the windy day, we cannot see or wind, we cannot see moon or stars in the sky. Whenever the wind is high, the wind is high means very high speed wind. Whenever the wind is high, the wind is very high speed. Okay? All night long in the dark and wet, because you know all night, the whole night the wind is high speed, it is coming and dark, rainy season, you know, everywhere wet, watering and wet, dark and wet, you know, you can understand the rainy season, the windy day outside. A man goes riding by in this high wind, high speed wind is blowing and blowing high speed. That time a man goes riding by. Here the picture you can see, the man is riding on the horse. Here the man is nobody else, but it is the wind itself. The man is nobody else, it is the wind itself. Late in the night, when the fires are out, why does he gallop and gallop about? Whenever the trees are crying aloud and the ships are tossed at sea. Here, you see, the trees are crying aloud. The wind is moving through the trees, making noise, you know. Wind is moving through the trees. Tree will make a noise bending there and here, and the leaves will make a such a loud noise when very high speed of wind is coming. So sound also very loudly we can hear. The ships are tossed at sea. Here the ships are tossed at sea. The ships are moved up and down the waves, you know, in the sea. The ships are, if a wind is there, wind is blowing, the sea, the ships and boats, it will move up and down like that. It will move going up and coming down. Both sides will come like that. So by on the highway, low and loud. The highway, the wind is blowing through the seas, through the trees and through the highways. Wind will move everywhere very forcefully, and at the gallop goes he. But if a wind is coming, one high speed wind is coming and going, again there will be, again it wind is coming and going. Gallop means high speed. So wind is coming high speed, going again it will come very slow, again it will come high speed. Wind is coming like that, coming go slow, high, loud, no, and slow it will come, goes and come, again wind will go, again will come. By he comes back at the gallop again, again high speed wind is coming or going through the seas, through the trees, through the houses, through highway, and wind is very fast, very high speed, coming all through night. And everywhere wet and watering. That's why the poem heading is Windy Night. The wind is picturized as a man. Here, the wind is picturized as a man on a horse. Actually, the man is not going on horse. It is picturized only the wind. In the wind, here is describing. Okay, it's not a man, real man. It is a picturizing, showing the picture, comparing this wind like this. Man is going riding on a high speed. Same way, wind also high speed, coming through the night. And the rider is enjoying. Means the wind over me high speed, that is wind is moving. So this wind high speed, this man is riding, means the wind coming and going, only that's the here picturized as a man riding on a horse. Wind is picturized here. This is windy day. Okay, nobody else. Okay, here the poet is associated with the wind to the moon and the stars late at night. The wind is picturized as a moon on a horseback who gallop on and make the tree ride and toss the ships at sea. The galloping horseman comes on off. The wind is portrayed as a mysterious force that is inevitable, avoidable. The wind we cannot stop. Wind will come high speed, will come, but we cannot tell stop. No, it will not remain there. Wind will come and go someday very high speed, someday low, very slowly wind will come, low speed will come, high speed will come. We cannot avoid it. Wind will come and go through different places, through the sea, through the trees and through the highways, through the houses, everywhere wind will come and go. We cannot avoid it. It is inevitable. We cannot avoid it. Okay, students, this lesson, small poem, very easy poem, very interesting poem, but you have to learn by heart this poem. Okay, and these meanings, spelling, and also you have to study. Here there is few exercises are there. Write true or false. The speaker can hear the man riding at night. The speaker can hear the riding on its stormy. Right. First and second is right. The third one, the rider hears the trees calling out to him. It is wrong. The rider goes up and down the highway because the wind will go through the highway. Say right. The speaker can hear the rider when the sea is calm. Wrong. It is the wind during the storm that sounds like the horse rider. Wrong, actually. Okay. B. What do these phrases from the poem mean? Tick. You have to tick. Correct answer. It's easy for you. Okay. You can understand that. Here there is a column. Poet has used several phrases with such a dark and wet, low and loud. Match the column. This column you have to match it. There down there is you have to write. Bright, sunny. Down, out. Now, then. Tooth, what is it mean? Tooth, nail. Up, about. Hue, cry. Hard, fast. Okay, you have to write. Then again, lesson 3, there is some more grammar part. Here, the page number 36. The few answers are there. Discuss answers in the question in class. So these things you have to, these two exercises we will discuss in the class. Face to face discussion with the children only. But we cannot discuss one person. So whenever you come to school, we will discuss this. Okay. The flowchart is there. This flowchart also. You already written lesson 1. There is flowchart is there. First happened things, write first matter. And second, then third. The last happened should write last. Here the worksheet tick and correct answers. Here early one morning, Rishi was waiting for the school bus at the bus stop. Second one, we first realized the stranger had an unusual power when he did a very complicated match sum in a moment. Third one, the stranger got upset because Rishi thought he was performing tricks. Fourth one, when the car slipped from Rishi's hands and fell at his feet, the stranger extended his right hand and picked it up. Then fifth, know that the meeting with the stranger really happened because Rishi still had the toy car in his bag. And think and answer are already I sent. Here there is the clue to complete the crossword and one sound word. Okay, here there is the first one is number 1 is chatter, number 3 thunder, number 5 clap, number 6 tingle, 7 mew, 8 below. First number cry, second trumpet, fourth rattle, fifth one clap, then and 8th one bark, 9th one wail. Next, fill in the blanks, choose from the words in brackets. That also so easy for you. The answer you have to, three choices are there, answer you have to tick there. Then grammar part, adjectives, what is adjectives? Words that describe or qualify nouns are called adjectives. Adjectives change in form to show comparison. Then forms of comparison are made by adding er, est. Already you studied comparison. Here see example, thick overcoat, thicker, er add here, thicker overcoat and again est, the thickest overcoat. Then white, whiter, whitest, hot, hotter, hottest. It's a comparative degree. Again, we can use two or three adjective noun, more than that is unusual and clumsy. We use adjectives to describe the size, shape, color and appearance. Or sometimes we put the size and the shape first, then the color and then other qualities. Okay, again worksheet H also here you have to write adjective, you have to underline. Here next one page 40 also there is picture is there, you have to tick adjectives from the exercises. Okay, lesson 3 we completed. Okay, and all of you study all the exercises and the questions, you have to complete lesson 3, then only start lesson 4. Okay, and study all of you well. Okay, and prepare. Okay, very well, thank you.